Welcome to our third video in the series of QuickBooks for Home Finance, Video 3, Preparing Your File. We will use two specific windows in QuickBooks to prepare the file for home use. We will use the Preferences window, and we will use the Customize Icon Bar window. The Preferences window is simply the defaults window. You can consider it the settings or the options. It's the window that controls the automatic behavior of the software, and every program has a defaults window that does this. Let's take a look at what we need to do. From the top left of the main menu, click Edit, and the very bottom choice in the submenu is Preferences. Here is your Preferences window. When you click on the left panel, you get different categories of preferences. Every category of preference has two sections, the My Preference tab and the Company Preference tab. We will be addressing specific items here to make your experience go very smoothly. First, click the top category, Accounting. I don't like that warnings pop up when you put any date you want in a transaction. So let's click these two check marks and remove the requirement for QuickBooks to warn us if we put in a date too far in the past or too far in the future. We can click OK and reopen the window, or we can simply click on a different category. If we click on a different category, you might get a warning message, so we'll address that in a moment. I don't like this home window. I believe it confuses people, especially if you're using QuickBooks for home finance. However, if you close it, it will keep opening up when you open the file. So if you click Edit Preferences and you click this category, Desktop View, you can click to remove the check mark so that the home window will no longer pop up. I also think it's a bad idea for QuickBooks to try to remember everything that was on your desktop when you close the file. It can be very messy. There's no important company preferences in the desktop view. Now again, you could click OK, but if you simply click another category, you'll get a warning from QuickBooks. Do you want to save the changes that you made in this category? You can just click yes. Now, here's where you really make your experience more convenient. You should click this box, turn off pop-up messages for products and services. They can be very distracting when you're trying to use QuickBooks, and every time you click on something, you know, it's a, hey, QuickBooks can do this for you. Hey, QuickBooks can do that for you. Just click this check mark and it will turn it off. If you like QuickBooks to beep every time you save something, you can leave this check mark. If you don't like it, you can click to remove. The only other preference that you need to change to make your experience a smooth one is down here when you click Reports and Graphs. Again, click yes to save the changes from the other category. And I believe it's very important to click here and make your reports refresh automatically. This way, as soon as you save a transaction, the report that shows your results will change immediately. Click OK, and that's pretty much all you need to do to adjust your preferences and your defaults and your settings to work with QuickBooks for Home Finance. Now, let's prepare the icon bar. From the main menu, the first thing you should do is click View and put the icon bar on top. That's a more traditional view, and it's much easier to see and manage the icons that you will use. To customize this bar to your preference and to your liking, click View and click Customize Icon Bar. And the Customize Icon Bar window opens up. I suggest you click Delete and remove every single item on the icon bar. This is because we will be putting up the icons that we need as we go along, and we will be putting them in an order that is very smooth and easy to use. We will learn more features of the customize icon bar as we apply it to setting up the file. Click OK, and now we're ready for the next step.